Paregoric, Wikipedia article audio. Paregoric, or camphorated tincture of opium, also known as tinctura opii camphorata, is a traditional patent remedy known for its antidiarrheal, antitussive, and analgesic properties. Properties. History. Use during the 20th century. Regulation. Regulation and use since 1970. Paregoric, USP formula. Dosage. Indications. According to Goodman and Gilman's 1965 edition, Paregoric is a 4% opium tincture in which there is also benzoic acid, camphor, and anise oil. Paregoric by tradition is used especially for children. In 1944, two clinicians who evaluated the expectorant action of paregoric, concluded. The survival of paregoric through the centuries, and particularly through recent critical decades, is probably due to keen clinical observation and stubborn adherence to the clinical deduction that paregoric is useful in certain types of cough. In the very early 18th century, Jacob L. E. Mort, a professor of chemistry at Leiden University, prepared an elixir for asthma and called it paregoric. The word paregoric comes from the Greek word paregorikon, which was originally applied to oratory, to speak, but, more accurately, talk over, soothe, and finally came to have the same meaning as anodyne. L. E. Mort's elixir consisted of honey, licorice, flowers of Benjamin, and opium, camphor, oil of aniseed, salt of tartar and spirit of wine, became official as Elixir Asthmaticum in the London Pharmacopoeia of 1721. Its ingredients were assembled out of the obsolete humoral philosophy and quasi-scientific reasoning of the Renaissance. Paregoric was used in various formulations for hundreds of years. Paregoric was a household remedy in the 18th and 19th centuries when it was widely used to control diarrhea in adults and children, as an expectorant and cough medicine, to calm fretful children, and to rub on the gums to counteract the pain from teething. Two formulas, one for paregoric and another for a similar medication, taken from an 1870 publication, are: for paregoric, best opium 1/2 dr, dissolve it in about 2 tablespoons of boiling water, then add benzoic acid 1/2 dr, oil of anise 1/2 fluid dr, clarified honey 1 ounce, camphor gum 1 scruple, alcohol, 76%, 11 fluid ounces, distilled water 4 1/2 fluid ounces, macerate, for 2 weeks. Dose for children, 5 to 20 drops, adults, 1 to 2 teaspoons. The other, for Bateman's pectoral drops, is opium in powder, catechu in powder, camphor gum, red saunders, rasped, of each 1/2 ounce, oil of anise 1 dr, dilute alcohol, 1 gal. Keep warm for 2 weeks. The opium strength of this is about equal to paregoric, and it is used for similar purposes, and doses. During the 20th century, its use declined as governments regulated its ingredients. Beginning in late 2011, there was a period in which paregoric was not being manufactured in the United States. As of August 2012, however, the manufacture of paregoric has resumed. The early 20th century brought increased regulation of all manner of narcotics, including paregoric, as the addictive properties of opium became more widely understood, and patent medicines came under fire largely because of their mysterious compositions. In the United States, the Pure Food and Drug Act of 1906 required that certain specified drugs, including alcohol, cocaine, heroin, morphine, and cannabis, be accurately labeled with contents and dosage. Previously, many drugs had been sold as patent medicines with secret ingredients or misleading labels. Cocaine, heroin, cannabis, and other such drugs continued to be legally available without prescription as long as they were labeled. It is estimated that sale of patent medicines containing opiates decreased by 33% after labeling was mandated. In 1906 in Britain and in 1908 in Canada, laws requiring disclosure of ingredients and limitation of narcotic content were instituted. The Harrison Narcotics Act of 1914 restricted the manufacture and distribution of opiates, including laudanum and coca derivatives in the United States. This was followed by France's Loi des Stupefiants in 1916, and Britain's Dangerous Drugs Act in 1920. In the United States, the Harrison Narcotics Act of 1914 regulated opium or coca leaves, or any compound, manufacture, salt, derivative or preparation thereof, but not some medical products containing relatively low concentrations of these substances. Paregoric was classified as an exempt narcotic, as were other medical products containing small amounts of opium or their derivatives. In 1929-30, Park, Davis & Co., a major United States drug manufacturer based in Detroit, Michigan, sold opium, USP, as tincture number 23 for $10.80 per pint, and opium camphorated, USP, as tincture number 20, for $2.20 per pint. Concentrated versions were available. Opium camphorated, for USP. Tincture, liquid number 338 was exactly 8 times the strength of tincture opium camphorated, U.S.P., designed for preparing the tincture by direct dilution, and cost $7 per pint. Similarly, at a cost of $36 per pint, opium concentrated, for USP. Tincture, liquid No. 336, was 4 times the strength of the official tincture, and designed for the extemporaneous preparation of the tincture. The catalog also noted, for quarter pint bottles add 80c per pint to the price given for pints. Until 1970, Paregoric could be purchased in the United States at a pharmacy without a medical prescription, in accordance with federal law. Federal law dictated that no more than 2 ounces of Paregoric be dispensed by any pharmacy to the same purchaser within a 48-hour period. Purchasers were also required to sign a register or logbook, and pharmacies were technically required to request identification from any purchaser not personally known to the pharmacist. Some states further limited the sale of Paregoric, or banned over-the-counter sales entirely. For example, Michigan law allowed over-the-counter sale of Paregoric until April 1964, but still allowed OTC sales of certain exempt cough medication preparations that contain 60 mg of codeine per fluid ounce. Even where legally permissible by law, OTC sale of Paregoric was subject to the discretion of individual pharmacists. In 1970, Paregoric was classified as a Schedule III drug under the Controlled Substances Act. However, drugs that contained a mixture of kaolin, pectin, and paregoric were classified as Schedule V drugs. They were available over-the-counter without a prescription in many states until the early 1990s, at which time the FDA banned the sale of antidiarrheal drugs containing kaolin and pectin. Paregoric is currently listed in the United States Pharmacopeia. Manufacture of the drug was discontinued for several months beginning in late 2011, however, production and distribution resumed in 2012, so the drug is still available in the United States by prescription. Thus, it is unclear as to whether the lapse in manufacture actually resulted in a shortage of the drug at any time, since prescription drugs are often still available for many months after manufacture has been discontinued. In France, Paregoric was available without prescription until 1986. Nowadays, it is used to wean infants born to opiate-addicted women. The principal active ingredient in Paregoric is powdered opium. In the United States, the formula for Paregoric, USP, is tincture of opium 40 ml, anise oil 4 ml, benzoic acid 4 g, camphor 4 g, glycerin 40 ml, alcohol 450 ml, purified water 450 ml, diluted alcohol to 1000 ml, and contains the equivalent of 0.4 mg/ml of anhydrous morphine. 1 ounce of Paregoric contains 129.6 mg of powdered opium, or the equivalent of 13 mg of anhydrous morphine. The average adult dose is 4 ml by mouth, which corresponds to 16 mg of opium, or 1.6 mg of anhydrous morphine. It is unclear when the current formula for Paregoric, USP, was developed in the United States, and more research is needed. For example, one formula for camphorated tincture of opium attributed to the United States Pharmacopeia of 1863 is: macerate 1 dram each powdered opium and benzoic acid, 1 fluid dram of anise, 2 ounces clarified honey, and 2 scruples camphor, in 2 pints diluted alcohol for 7 days, and filter through paper. A slightly different formula is given in the 1926 Pharmacopeia. The current formula for Paregoric, USP, should not be assumed to be universal. For example, in the United Kingdom, the formula for Paregoric, BP, is tincture of opium 5 ml, benzoic acid 500 mg, camphor 300 mg, anise oil 0.3 ml, alcohol to 100 ml, and contains about 1/30th grain of anhydrous morphine in 60 minims, which is 25% stronger than Paregoric, USP. Paregoric is sometimes confused with laudanum, because their chemical names are similar, camphorated tincture of opium vs. tincture of opium. However, laudanum contains 10 mg of morphine per milliliter, 25 times more than Paregoric. Confusion between the two drugs has led to overdose and deaths in several patients. Thus, the term Paregoric should be used instead of camphorated opium tincture, since the latter may be confused with laudanum. The differences between tincture of opium and camphorated tincture of opium are important and should be kept in mind when administering either of these drugs. Care and caution should always be taken in administering doses of tincture of opium, such as the use of a dosage syringe or other suitable measurement device, and by pharmacists in preparing Paregoric from laudanum, and to note that the dosages noted here refer to apothecary's weight and fluid measure. In particular, the difference between a minim and a drop should be borne in mind when figuring doses. A minim is always a 60th part of a fluid dram regardless of the character of the substance, while a drop varies from a 45th to a 250th part, according to the surface tension of the fluid. Tincture of opium and camphorated tincture of opium each have 50.9 drops per gram, 50.0 drops per cc, 185.0 drops per fluid dram, and 3.10 drops per minim. The importance of these distinctions is evident in view of the dangers of erroneously relying upon more general descriptions of apothecaries' fluid measures, which typically list 60 minims per fluid dram, and 8 fluid drams per fluid ounce. The main effects of paregoric are to increase the muscular tone of the intestine, to inhibit normal peristalsis, and as an expectorant, a peer-reviewed clinical study in 1944 reported that all of ingredients have been found to contribute toward the expectorant action of paregoric, and, further, that an advantage is contained in the combination over the sum of the effects of the individual constituents, that paregoric is expectorant by virtue of a reflex from the stomach, and preparations of paregoric which have aged for 2 or 3 years are superior as an expectorant to preparations aged for less time. Its main medical use is to control fulminant diarrhea, and as an antitussive. Problems with its use include opiate dependency and analgesia, which can mask symptoms of diseases that need treatment. However, paregoric was characterized as a needlessly complex pharmacopoeial mixture, of a former date by a 1966 study. In the 21st century, its two main uses have been largely supplanted by minimally psychoactive cough suppressant drugs and non-psychoactive antidiarrheal drugs.